properties of task environment. The task environment will be categorized using the following types. The first one is fully observable versus partially observable. This is the first category of task environment. The second one is the deterministic versus stochastic. It is the second category of task environment. The third one is episodic and versus sequential. Then fourth one is static versus dynamic. And the fifth one is discrete versus continuous. And the sixth one is single agent versus multi-agent. These are the six categories of task environment. Okay. So we'll be discussing this categories of task environment one by one now. So the first category is fully observable versus partially observable. Okay. So when agent sensors give its access to the complete state of environment at a point in a time, then we say that the task environment is fully observable. Means it is that the environment should be completely observable by the agent sensors. Agent sensors only giving the input to the system, yes or no? So the agent sensors should be able to get complete information about the environment at any given time. Then we say that the particular task environment is completely observable. Okay. So the task environment is efficiently fully observable if sensor detects all accepts that are relevant to the choice of action. Relevance in terms depends on the performance measure. So the sensors should be able to detect complete information from the environment so that it is able to take the particular choice of action. Okay, agent will, after receiving the information, agent will be taking some actions, yes or no? So when to take the action, it has to completely observe the environment. So whatever parameters it requires to take the action, all the parameters it is able to observe from the environment, then we say that that particular environment is fully observable. So if, for example, if the environment is partially observable because of noise, incorrect sensors, because part of the state are simply missing from the sensor data. So in that case, the environment becomes partially observable. So whenever there are incorrect sensors, the sensors cannot perceive the complete information. And if there is a noise, then also it cannot perceive the information. And because some part of the state are simply missing from the sensor data. So from the sensor data, some information is missing. In that case also, it is cannot completely observe the environment. Then that case, this is called partially observable environment. For example, if you take vacuum agent with only local dirt sensors, it is having only local dirt sensors. So it can tell whether the dirt is there in the local, in particular area, in that area only. So it cannot tell about whether there is a dirt in the other squares because it does not have the global sensor, dirt sensors. It is having local dirt sensors. So that it cannot tell whether the dirt is in other squares. So what type of agent it is? It is called partially observable environment because what is the drawback here? It is having only local dirt sensors. That is why it is not able to give the information about whether the dirt is present in the other square or not. Okay. The second category of task environment is the deterministic versus stochastic. So when you say that the environment is deterministic here, the next state of environment is completely determined by the current state and the actions executed by the agent. Okay, so when some actions are executed by the agent, what happens? The environment will be moving from one state to the other state. So the next state of environment is completely determined by the current state and actions executed by the agent. Then the environment is called deterministic. Otherwise, the environment is called stochastic. So in principle, here, the agent need not worry about uncertainties in fully observable and deterministic environment. So agent will be successful only in deterministic and fully observable environment because it is able to find what is the next state. And since it is fully observable, it will have complete information to take the actions. Okay, so that is why So the agent need not worry about uncertainties. If there are any uncertainties in the fully observable and deterministic environment, agent need not worry about that. Okay. Then the agent is partially observable, then it could appear to be stochastic. So usually in partially observable environment, what happens? It does not have the complete information about the environment, so that it cannot determine the next state of environment from the current state as well as the actions performed by the agent. Okay, so that is why the agent, the particular task environment is stochastic in the case of partially observable environment. And here we also have strategic. Strategic is that environment is deterministic except for the actions of other agents. Okay, so it is a deterministic environment only, but it is except for the actions of other agents. Only for that agent, which is the agent we are discussing about, it is deterministic. So it is for other agents' actions, it is except for other agents' action, the environment is deterministic. In that case, the environment is called strategic. So what is strategic? The environment is deterministic except for actions of other agents. So in that case, the environment is called strategic. So the examples here, we see that taxi driving is clearly stochastic environment, because so one can never predict the behavior of traffic exactly. And moreover, sometimes the tires will blow off engine. There will be a problem in the engine. Okay, so we cannot expect all this. That is why taxi driving is clearly stochastic environment. Whereas vacuum cleaning agent, vacuum world is deterministic agent. Okay, so here because of other agent, the traffic behavior. So if there is any problem with the tires, or if there is any problem with the engine, this cannot be predicted. So that is why this taxi driving environment is clearly stochastic environment, whereas vacuum world is deterministic environment. If the sensors, what is that? When it is deterministic, it is fully observable. If it is fully observable, means all the sensors are getting the information, the complete information about the task environment. Okay, so that is why vacuum world is deterministic. The third category of task environment is episodic versus sequential. So what is episodic here? If you take any action, so what happens here? The environment the agent experience will be divided into small episodes. Okay, so atomic episodes. So in episodic task environment, agent, whatever agent action it has to perform, that is divided into small atomic episodes. Okay, so each episode consists of agent perceiving then performing single action. So for example, in that particular episode, what it has to do, it has to perceiving some information and performing only the particular single action in that. Okay, so the next episode, so when it is completing one episode, when it is going to the next episode does not depend on actions taken in the previous episode. Okay, so in episodic environment, choice of action in each episode depends on episode itself. Okay, so the next episode actions does not depend upon previous episode. So what happens, the choice of actions in each episode depends only on episode itself. Okay, like that, the complete agent action will be divided into small episodes, so that it will perform, after performing one episode, it is going to the other episode. So whatever actions it is performing in one episode depends only on that episode itself. It does not depend on the next episode or previous episode. Okay. So example, you take this, the agent that has to spot defective parts on assembly line. Okay. So what is that here? That we have a part picking robot. It has to spot the defective parts on assembly lane. So each decision on current part regardless of previous part. Okay, it does not depend on previous part. So in current location, whether that particular part is defective or not, that only it will be checking. Okay, so it does not depend on previous decision or future decisions. Then in sequential environment, on the other hand, the current decision could affect all future decisions. Okay, so whatever decision we are taking, current decision, that will affect all future decisions. That is called sequential environment. For example, you take chess, taxi driving are sequential in both cases, because the short term actions can have long term sequences. Because in chess also, whatever action you are taking, that will affect the next action, is that no? And in taxi driving also, whatever action we are performing, that will be affecting the next action. Okay, so it is sequential environment. So in this case, short-term actions can have long-term consequences. So from this, we can say that episodic environment are much simpler than sequential environment, because we are dividing the complete action into small episodes. Okay, so that is why it is much simpler than sequential environment, because agent does not need to think ahead. So it is just thinking about that particular episode. Once it completes that episode, it is going to the next episode. Okay, so that is why agent does not need to think ahead.